This does not look like an X13.
What do we have here? External DC motor for fan. Interesting.
Yeah.
Very, very interesting. You have 310 volts DC, 600 watts, 1300 revolutions per minute. But what's most fascinating about this, the blowing wheel is how there's notches on every little vein here. And that's not something you see anywhere else. And it's pretty cool, I think. I happen to like it.
Yeah.
I also think, and again, I'm not an engineer, but it's also one more surface area for dirt to get attracted to. You agree?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, pretty fascinating. How is it? Looks, everything looks spot welded together. We have a Phillips screw holding in this little diverter. And a little baby motor for 18,000 BTU air handler. Three wire. We have nice rubber vibration pads on our blower motor mounting bracket. And looking inside the, you know what? It's feel the insulation inside here. How does it? What's your honest opinion?
It's like duckboard. It's like duckboard.
Yeah, but it feels more. I think it feels like a better quality than you have in like a carrier or a ream. Mm-hmm. And how many times you take the cover off, the front cover off, like an air handler, and you know, the piece is flopping in the wind, but look how, wow, actually it is duckboard. Look at that.
Yeah.
It is thick insulation.
Huh.
And still a fraction of the price of the competition.
Very cool.
It's crazy. Very, very cool. So we basically disassembled the entire air handler. Let's take a look at the evaporator coil. We have, and which is what I love, we have flare connections on all of our line set connections, both at the evaporator coil and the condensing unit outside. And they give us the adapters to, so you don't have to flare while you're on site. But this allows you to possibly use zoomlock during the entire installation. And, you know, I see some, a lot of Instagram HVAC guys, they cut just the bell off, mm-hmm, with a swedge connection off, and then they slide on a zoom lock. And you know that once that's on there, there's no going back.
Right.
Right. If that goes bad, like you need to like get inside there. You're not getting in there. So here we have an electronic expansion valve, a motorized expansion valve. And we have dozens of thermistors, temperature sensors. And here we have our A2L flammable refrigerant vapor sensor, which I'm pretty sure is a requirement now. But does it really just sit there? It's like that. Yeah, I guess it does. It's like there. Was there a screw there?
Maybe the cover.
Yeah, maybe. We have a pan for vertical installation and horizontal. So it's multi-positional. And it's nice, and you can put your electric heating element there for emergency heating operation.
Is it downflow also, or?
That's a good question. Let's look at the manual. All right, so while Mike is studying the manual, he likes to read manuals before he installs anything for the first time, and it's always a good idea to RTFM, read the factory manual. Mm-hmm. Tyreek and I have been working on this Modine hot dog. Modine, also a sponsor of the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy Charitable Organization. We are getting a little creative here, and we're thinking outside the box. We noticed that there are 3/8 threaded rod connections both on all sides, with the exception of the rear and the front of this hot dog. This is their Hydronic version, as opposed to that, which is a gas version. And we modified a little bit. They probably are not going to approve of it, but it's only for lab testing. It's not installed in the real world. We use some 3/8 plates here, and we made some stilts because we're going to take this Modine and put it on top of that US Boiler X2, and we're going to screw them down just like that. And I didn't want to rest it directly on top of the boiler, but I also wanted to be able to get to the supply and return the hot water out and hot water in and connect it to our zoning off of the boiler here. And what would really, really be nice if they made it like a little baby indirect water heater.
Exactly.
We could put like a little 5-gallon water heater right here. Imagine we made one.
Yo.
We could make one.
I'm curious.
We could make an indirect water heater. We would need a bucket, like a pail, mm-hmm. with a nice lid. And then we could take some coiled copper and put it in there and have that feed water from a zone. The coil will heat the water. Mm-hmm. We really wouldn't keep it under pressure, but we could create like an immersion like heater. And it would dip into the water. We could drain the water out of the little bucket. That would be pretty cool. But we're going to take that Modine and put it right up here. Okay, a little bit better.
Yeah.
Make those a little bit wider so you have better leverage. Not too wide, but, you know, just... All right, I'm going to tighten up the rest of them, and then we're going to put this on top of the US Boiler X2. I don't know how much we're going to get done today with it, but at least we'll get it in place and screw it to the top of the boiler. Okay, I tasked Mike with investigating in the manual, is there a minimum line set length? And what did you find?
Did not see anything about minimum line set length. I did see about bends.
Okay. Do bends equal a certain amount of feet?
No, not gonna
see something. No. What do
we got? Minimum bend radius. Carefully bend tubing in the middle. According to the diagram below, do not bend the tubing more than 90 degrees.
Correct.
Minimum radius, 3.9.
When we were bending the pipe.
Yeah.
Okay. You don't want to bend more than 90 degrees. Correct. Because that you could compromise the integrity of the pipe, but also kink it as well. But also probably not good for it as well, either. But we're using long turn 90s, we're good. And if we're using a bender, and as long as we're not exceeding a 90 degree inside turn or turn, then we're good as well. No?
I believe so, yeah.
Pretty impressive though. All right, let's see what's not level. All right, so we are not that level there. I'm going to guess that if we bring this down a little bit, if it's possible to bring this down a little bit, or we increase the height of this. Yeah. So let's loosen up that nut right there. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. And remember, this whole thing's going to want to turn because you probably did super strength on it.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Now, let's... Okay, and now the other one, let's see how this looks from afar. Stand right here, tell me what this looks like. Mike, come here, stand. What the hell does that thing look like on top?
It's like an automated robot.
It does look like a robot. Yep. Does not compute. That thing's going to be pretty cool, though. Imagine when this thing's firing up and we can adjust these louvers. Right? Like that. And we can force some of this air down. Oh, come on. And then you could be like cooking. Mm. Now look, it even looks more like a robot now. Like,
yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta get little sticky eyes.
We should get little eyes for the top of it. We'll decorate it.
You got the tin hat at the top of the logo.
Okay. So you have your supply manifold, mm-hmm. which is how many zones?
Two.
And what is this called?
This will be your return.
Correct. So now you need to picture in your head how you're going to connect this to where here? Where are you going to put it there? Where?
Since this is your supply,
yep.
it'll go to the hot water end.
Correct. Excellent. And where does this one go?
This will go on this manifold.
Okay. Now, what you need to do, I would like you to take a picture of this. And your homework between the next time we come, which will probably be next Monday, or if you feel like you want to come here during the week as well, or in the afternoon, let me know. You have my cell number. Text me and call me. We'll figure something out. If Monday doesn't work for you, want to do a different night, I'm fine with that. He's right down the block. We could figure it out. But I want to spend some more time with you because you I know you want to learn this.
Yeah.
He wants to learn that, but I also want to dedicate some more one-on-one time. I want you to take a picture of this, and I want you to picture how and what you need. That's the question. Mm-hmm. To connect from here, 3/4 inch male pipe thread mm-hmm. to 1/2 inch copper sweat.
Okay.
Right? And I'm not asking about everything that you need, but I want you to draw out how it's going to be and what you need for it to work.
Got it.
Right? Just like we needed a circulator here to get our primary loop flowing, mm-hmm. right? We're going to need, are we going to need one of those there? Are we going to need a circulator on here or here?
Yeah, because we need water to push up.
Correct. Yes, and we want to pump away. Yeah. So we'll probably put a circulator here. Now, I want you to take you see, they took a picture of this, right?
Yeah.
Now, I want you to come over here. There's a 3-loop manifold, right?
Mm-hmm.
With a couple circulators. They're two different types, right? One's Grumpus, one's Taco, one's not even being used, right?
Yeah.
But you see how I pretend that's the box that we just hung on the wall, hung on top of the boiler, okay. right? If we follow it, it goes to here, probably, right? So we need to go from here to our coil and then back to there, the copper.
Copper.
These. That's our return.
Okay.
I didn't use this. I had some things I had, like, you know, from scrap from a boiler, so I just did what I could to build this. Like, this is scrap from a boiler. I cleaned it up with a wire brush wheel. And a drill, and it looks brand new. You took that apart last week.
Yeah, we took out the air sac.
Yeah, today. And the pressure is still there, and there's no leaks. I came here Tuesday morning, and the first thing I did was look for leaks. There were no leaks here.
A mechanic already.
Look at that, see? Not too shabby. So, you see what you have what you have here. You're going to have to do something similar over there. Okay. Right? So, I don't want to give away all the answers, but I also don't want you to fail miserably.
Okay.
Right here, we have a threaded male connection. So ideally, you could take a circulator flange here and put a circulator, another circulator flange here, and then go into here somehow, some way with copper,
okay.
right? But if you want to be able to isolate this, let's say this has a hole in it or a crack, it freezes, whatever.
Okay.
If I close this off here with a valve and I close this off here with a valve, the rest of my loops,
mm-hmm.
right, if I have multiple zones, won't be disturbed.
Okay.
Right? Just like I had it over there, I had a valve before the circulator, right? And a valve after.
Mm-hmm.
These are just much bigger because this is 1¼-inch pipe. So we're going to need a 3/4-inch circulator isolation flange. Mm-hmm. You're going to need a circulator. You're going to need another circulator isolation flange, maybe with a purge, so we can purge out water. Mm-hmm. And then you'll probably be somewhere here. And then a little bit of some copper. 1/2 inch, and then maybe like 3/4 by 1/2 inch reducing coupling there. And that will be our supply side. Our return side, I see how you pointed it down.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's thinking a little bit outside the box. What you can also, now you also notice how this is sticking out a lot here.
Yeah.
Right? If I were to put a 90 here, or a street 90 here, right?
Mm-hmm.
I would need to support this up, right?
Okay.
And with either some kind of threaded rod, but I can't because it's beyond the pass of my base. So this is okay the way you're doing it now because this, all of this is holding this up. And this threaded rod is making sure this doesn't fold down.
Okay.
So this is okay for now. But normally, if you had limited space here, you have to put a 90 here, you would need to hold this up. Mm-hmm. Because the weight of the circulators, and plus it also needs to be supported. By mechanical code says you need to have support X amount of feet on a horizontal run, plus with dealing with weight. Like, I don't have to have this here, but I should. Because the weight of this is going to push this down, which could force all this to tumble down. Yeah. And I could, look. Actually, no, you can't because that's there now. Cool. And this other one, we'll just cap, and we'll put another valve here to isolate this for future use.
Okay.
Cool? Not too shabby, ladies and gentlemen. So we just finished our sixth class. It's 8:30 on Monday evening. We're going to keep going with this class, but I am taking reservations for future classes. If you like a application to sign up for the Mikey Pipes HVAC training class, it's free of charge, by the way, at least for now it is. If I turn into a real school where people actually learn and retain like what this is called, then we'll have to charge something. But for now, we're having fun, we're learning, and we are making the trades great again. We really are. And a huge shout out to the folks over at Modine for supplying us the hot dog. They may not like how I'm mounting it here, looking like a robot, but Tyreek was quite skilled in installing the supply and return manifolds. We're going to pipe this in. I gave him some homework to draw this out. Take a picture and draw this out on how we're going to connect this 3/4 inch male pipe thread to that 1/2 inch, and then back down to here. We're going to make it happen. He's going to do it. And stick around for next week's show when we get that done. It's awesome, guys. It's awesome. And real quick, I want to touch on the ACiQ system, the opportunity to private label your own HVAC equipment, heat pump technology, side discharge condensing units. One of the best things I love about this, automatic switching between 110 to 240 volts. Amazing. Amazing. 7-year parts, 12-year compressor warranty. Bundle it with a 10-year protection plan for parts and labor through like JB Warranties or AIG, whoever your company uses. It's a win-win for not only your homeowner, but for you as well. If you want any more information on how to become an ACiQ dealer and private label your own equipment, or even sell ACiQ. Details in the description box down below or visit aciq.com/MikeyPipes. Tell them I sent you. They'll give me an attaboy and give a pat in the back. I'll catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe. And remember, every Friday after 1 o'clock until Labor Day, we have the free Friday events here at 1010 Central Avenue in Woodmere. Bring your hot wife. Take a selfie on the bench outside. Have some hot dogs, french fries, cotton candy, popcorn, even have some goose. We got goose in the house, baby. Come on. What are you waiting for? Come on down Friday at 1 o'clock. Catch the next one. Love you guys.